Why us? Well, that's because Harborview is one of the nation's premier trauma centers, a level one. It's already set up for the kind of viruses that Ebola represents. Now, we asked and we were told that an Ebola patient's room here at Harborview would be just like any other room at Harborview, just with strict isolation to keep the virus from spreading. A lot of reactions still coming in on social media. Please go to our Cairo 7 Facebook page to see what others are saying and to add your response. Reporting live at Harborview Medical Center, Essex Porter, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
Yeah, Monique, both of them are students. Both of them have jobs and no criminal records. But today the judge did say that they do deserve to be punished for shimmying up the building you see behind me, sliding along the ledge, and then crawling in through an unlocked window at the governor's office. Also today, we heard them say they're sorry for the very first time. The judge today also agreed to allow both women to serve their 20 days where they live. Hutsicker goes to school in Portland, and Camilla lives and works and is enrolling in school in Seattle. They will both be on probation for 2 years. Live at the Capitol, Joanna Small, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
We're aboard a special tank car from Burlington Northern Santa Fe. This travels around the country helping train firefighters on hazardous materials. And today we came along as Seattle firefighters used it. And of course, everyone these days is thinking about oil train disasters.
The railroad says by the end of this year, it will have trained 800 firefighters in Washington State and 2,000 over the past 3 years. In Seattle, Graham Johnson, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
No, they can't, Angela, because after all, it is a federal holiday. But what they can do is change the name, at least for the city of Seattle. And that generated fierce emotions. Now, after the vote, I did talk to an Italian American, and he tells me his community feels the city council has, quote, thrown them under the bus, that their fight has only just begun.
And it was the Seattle Police Department's own internal watchdog group that actually caught this lax management of overtime. And today the city. But the main reason Chief O'Toole was in front of the city council was to go over a hate crime report that came out. I've got a copy of that report right here, and I've been going over it page by page, putting together a story, breaking down all the statistics for you, some interesting stuff about how the population growth here in Capitol Hill is contributing to that. Live on Capitol Hill, Henry Rossoff, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
Yeah, this all started right here at 8th Avenue South and South Forest, Steve, when a carjacker wielding a box cutter went right over here where you're looking at the MTS Western Bus Company. He pulled a woman who was working here out of her car trying to carjack the woman, but somebody, a good Samaritan, rushed over with a van and blocked that car in. So the carjacker ran off. Take that suspect down. Now, moments ago, I just talked to that very brave man, the manager at this bus company, who bravely stepped in and took that armed carjacker away from the person who was attacking him. We're wrapping up that interview right now. We'll send it back to Cairo and show it to you tonight at 6. For now, reporting live in Soto, I'm Gary Horker, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
And we happen to be here at Gatewood really to cover what is also a day of joy here at Gatewood Elementary. Then just after 2 o'clock, we saw police officers start to arrive walking very calmly to the door. Now, again, no one was hurt here, and one of the teachers really was very concerned that he not see our television cameras as he left for fear that it would make him even more anxious. This incident does point out why parents have been scrambling to raise $90,000 on their own to keep class sizes small here at Gatewood Elementary. We're finishing up that emotional story right now. We'll be back live at 5:30 to bring it to you. For now, reporting live in Seattle, Essex Porter, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
And I've been pressing the Centers for Disease Control for answers about why there are not more preventative measures here for 2 days. Now, this says other more extreme preventative measures are being put into place at other airports across the country, but nothing being done here at SeaTac. The feds say this fever screening process at those 5 airports do cover about 94% of all people coming to the United States from West Africa. They also emphasize that everyone leaving West Africa directly is subject to outbound screening, so they're hoping that does help. But we will continue to push for answers about why no measures here at SeaTac. Live at SeaTac Airport, Henry Rossoff, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
They are, Monique, in consultation with health inspectors. From this spot, I can see a Starbucks that is now back open again. And over here, a Bennett's is advertising for happy hour. There's an Italian place open. And this Vietnamese place, though, is not yet back open. And some business owners tell me they worry that customers will be hesitant to come back because the source of the E. coli has not been found. Officials here are not giving up on finding the source of the E. coli. They are bringing in outside experts to even more thoroughly go through the system, and they're also planning upgrades to the water tanks here. Now, today I asked if customers would be getting a break on their water bills. We're putting that part of the story together for 5:30. Live for now on Mercer Island, Graham Johnson, Cairo 7, Eyewitness News.
And it has been a whirlwind here since parents got word just a week ago they would have it basically until now to raise a nearly impossible amount of money. And when we got here this afternoon, some still didn't believe they had done it. Well, the final totals aren't in yet, but it looks like the parents raised about $65,000. Now, the district found some grant money and chipped in about $21,000. So now there is money to keep the teacher here at Gatewood and still money to hire another teacher for Fairmont Park Elementary, which needs a teacher. Reporting live in West Seattle, Essex, Porter Cairo 7, Eyewitness News.
And there's a lot of relief on this island, Steve. I want to show you the pink signs that are showing up at restaurants along Mercer Island with a message business owners are happy to spread. The island has been hit hard by the discovery of E. coli. Today, the city asked residents to help flush out the water in their homes. They asked people to turn on their pipes, the cold water, for 5 minutes, beginning on the top floor of their home. Live on Mercer Island, Graham Johnson, Cairo 7 Eyewitness News.
Each defendant received the maximum sentence today, more than 25 years in prison each, for a crime the senior prosecuting attorney called the most disturbing she has ever seen. If both serve their full sentences, they'll get out of prison when they're in their mid-40s. Reporting in Seattle, Amy Clancy, Cairo 7, Eyewitness News.